Hi everyone! I'm very excited for this video because it's my first collaboration on YouTube, and not the only one though. And it is with an artist from Germany. Her name is Pia, I think that's how it's pronounced. And she's a very young artist, she's just 16 and already taking her art seriously, sharing on YouTube, on Instagram. I'll put all the links in the description below and everywhere I can so that you can find her channel and watch her video too. She's also decided to do her first English voiceover for this collaboration specifically, so I appreciate that, and I think she's very brave to do that. Now, how does this all work? We decided that each one of us would pick an older painting of the other one and repaint it in our own way. I picked this painting of hers, and I will explain later exactly why I made this choice, and I ended up painting this one, which is similar to hers, but not exactly like hers. It is in my own style, but the base is the same with her concept and her original idea for the painting. Enough looking at me though, let's get straight into the time lapse and I will tell you exactly what happened with the creation of this piece. First of all, I decided to do this painting in my sketchbook and not on a normal canvas or board because it is her original idea, I wouldn't be selling it, so I thought that I would take this opportunity and experiment with oils in my sketchbook. Now, I didn't go straight on top of the paper and paint with oils, I applied a thin layer of gesso before doing that, and it worked very well. It did warp the paper just a little bit, but not too much, and I think it's a great idea to be able to paint with my oils in my sketchbook, and I'm very excited to do more of these in the future. As you can see already, with a collaboration like this, it was a perfect opportunity to step out of my comfort zone for one more time and do something different, which is extra exciting for me, and you know that already. I would also like to say that the tan color of the paper worked very well, it helped me see my values better, and I understand now why other artists apply a thin color of paint on top of their canvas before starting their painting. I will definitely consider that for the future. I did take a clear gesso instead of a white one, so I was able to see the tan of the paper, and I like that. I will use it in the future too. As for the artwork itself, I chose this painting specifically because I liked the colors, the theme, and the flow of the piece. I also had in mind a few photographs from Pixabay that I was excited to try for a while now. They were underwater shootings of beautiful women, and it was something that I definitely wanted to experiment with, and this opportunity seemed like the perfect opportunity to do that as well. You know I do like underwater themes, and these photographs were inspiring enough for me anyway, so I knew that I had a solid base to work from to recreate this piece in a nice way. I didn't want to copy exactly, I just wanted to keep the feel and the concept of the piece without exactly copying it. I wanted to add my own character and style in it without making it too different. I think that it is obvious and you can tell that one piece was created based on the other, even though they aren't exactly the same. I did try to keep the colors similar according to her choices, especially on the seaweeds, but I made my own choices as well. One element that I changed quite a lot and I use a little bit more lately in my paintings is that white texture with the palette knife in the end. I like the feel of it, I like how it adds some sparkle to the piece, and I thought that it would look like bubbles or add some magical essence to the piece, so I wanted to try it again and see how it would look. Painting on a sketchbook helps with these experiments because it doesn't feel like it would ruin a good canvas or a high quality board, and it is the perfect opportunity to experiment, especially in a collaboration, in a piece that doesn't add stress and pressure to the artist. I hope you liked my interpretation of her painting. She chose to repaint my own painting, Guarded, this one here, and she did a great job, so make sure you check her video out and show some support. She's very young, she's very talented, and she deserves all we can give her. Let's support each other because we're all artists and we all know how hard this is to do, and we should be more encouraging to each other. With this opportunity, I would like to encourage you to contact me if you'd like to do some kind of collaboration with me on YouTube. I'm open to new suggestions and new topics to collaborate on, and feel free to do that if you have a channel and you are making videos on YouTube. And that's it with this video and this time lapse. I hope you liked the artwork. Make sure you check her out. And please leave a thumbs up if you enjoyed watching, and as always, consider subscribing to my channel for more videos like this. I'm now uploading twice per week on Saturdays and Wednesdays. I hope to see you on the next video. Until then, be safe, be happy, and keep going for your dreams. Bye!